Check, check, check. Check, 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 check.
University Tigers. In a closely contested Atlantic Football League this season, this game has significant playoff implications. We ask you to please rise and remove your hats for our national anthem.
Thank you.
apology to the Tigers. We ask you now, please rise and remove your hats for our national anthem.
Good Sunday afternoon, Red Bomber, UNB alumni and Dalhousie Tiger fans, and especially hello to Cyril on a rainy October day in Fredericton, but any football day is a good day. So welcome to the Red Bombers versus the Dalhousie Tigers from Halifax, Nova Scotia. As the game progresses, as our friends from Aurora Productions will give images from BMO Field, we can see the autumn colors on the St. John River Valley, so it's a perfect football day. With the brand new field that the Red Bombers have, we should have no problem with the earlier wet conditions. So this is going to be an important game for both teams. Both of them have won their home games, and this will determine who's going to be first place right now in the Atlantic Football League, and we're away with the kickoff. Taken cleanly by UNB, coming up the middle. And a good stop just before the 30-yard line. It was Matt LaFleur who took that kickoff, so it's going to be first down and 10, Red Bombers.
Matt LaFleur with the return. He brings it out close to the 30-yard line. It'll be a first down.
And I need to mention that, unfortunately, my partner in crime, Justin Wise, isn't here. He had a prior engagement. But hello to Justin. He, of course, will be missed. But the greatest Cullen commentator in the history of university football should be back for our first playoff game. First down and 10, Red Bombers. And no surprise, if you've been watching the Red Bombers this season, that Cam Hayward up the middle for, looks like, about 4 or 5 yards.
Cam Hayward for the first play. Cam picks up what looks like 2 yards. It'll be second and 8.
And it was only a 2-yard gain, so it'll be second and 8. If you heard the dulcet tones of our on-field announcer, Jeff Landine. And it's complete. First down, Red Bombers. Thomas Hoyt was the receiver.
And he has the first UNB first down of the day.
So good beginning for the Red Bombers. It'll be first down and 10 from their own 42-yard line. Two receivers out to the right. Jonah Rawlines. A bit of play action away from one of the rushers. He's able to make a little gain up the middle, if anything at all.
Picks up what looks like a yard.
So Dalhousie defense was able to certainly change the plans of the Red Bombers on that play. Be second down and 8 for the Red Bombers. Motion to the left-hand side. Rawlines looks downfield to the left. Huge catch by number 3, Dom Hall. Red Bombers, first down. If we can get a replay on that. Wonderful pass by Rawlines. Dom Hall laying out for that reception. Well, there were going to be questions as to what offense we were going to see from UNB, whether it was going to be the vaunted running game behind that big offensive line or whether they're going to put the ball in the air. It looks like they've got both of those phases of their offense running. First down and 10. Cam Hayward off to the right-hand side, and it's a fumble.
Cam Hayward with the carry. And he fumbled.
Cam Hayward not able to take advantage of that big pass, so it's going to be a change of possession and first down and 10 for the Tigers on their own 37-yard line. So I understand there's been a roster change for the Dalhousie Tigers. The normal quarterback, Noah Glover, is out by injury, so it's Dante Gabrielli who is the quarterback for the Tigers today. Dive play up the middle. First player to meet him from the Red Bombers was Antonio Peterson. It'll be second down.
Dante Gabrielli in at quarterback for the Tigers. He hands off to Matt Lawton.
So for the Dalhousie Tigers coaches, the question is going to be, is Dante Gabrielli going to light up BMO Field with Dante's Inferno, or will this be a divine comedy? All you literary graduates will, of course, have a comment for that. Gabrielli looks deep. He's flushed out the middle. And a good gain. Close, should be very close to a first down.
Brought down by George Colpitz, but it looks like he's got a first down for the Tigers.
It is first down and 10 for the Tigers. On their own, just inside the 49-yard line. Trip receivers to the left of Gabrielli. And it's a dive play up the middle. Big hole put by the offensive line of Dalhousie. He's out of bounds, but with a great gain for a first down.
Gabrielli hands off to
Tigers march into Red Bomber territory with a first down and 10 on the Red Bomber close to their 48-yard line. Again, triple receivers to the left of Gabrielli. And Gabrielle keeps it himself with a big gain off to the right-hand side.
Gabrielle keeps again.
And another first down for the Tigers.
Knocked down by Nick Appleby, but not before he picks up a gain of 20. It'll be first down, Tigers.
So Gabrielle on fire for the Tigers. So it looks like it's more of the inferno that we're seeing right now from the Tigers offense. Trip receivers to the right. Dive play to the left-hand side. Good hole. Looks like about a five-yard gain. A little more than a five-yard gain for second down and probably about four and a half.
Ethan Ray, but picks up five. It'll be second and five, Tigers.
9:20 left in the first quarter. No score. Tigers marching. Gabrielli looking down the middle. Again, flushed out of the pocket. Quickly taken down by the, not only the Red Bomber defense, but the Red Bomber defense was able to take down the head referee.
Antonio Peterson.
Pat Fairweather, none the worse for wear.
Drop for no gain. It'll be third and five.
It'll be third down and a small loss. Looks like the Tigers are going to set up for a field goal. Okay, Kopenick will set up for the kick with Gabrielli doing the hold. Kick is blocked. Taken in the end zone and casually brought out by number 18, Sebastian Brown. So it'll be first down and 10 for the Red Bombers. No harm done. No points scored.
No points on the board. UNB will scrimmage first and 10 from their own 20.
So Andre Gauguin, the offensive coordinator for Dalhousie, must be disappointed with that, not to mention head coach Dave Kelly. So first down and 10 from their own 20, Red Bombers. 8 minutes left in the first quarter. Oh my goodness. And a big catch by the Red Bombers. Number
Rawlins pass. Contested and caught by Justin,
Remillard with a phenomenal catch. If we can see a replay of that, you can say that Rawlins was flushed out of the, not quite his best spiral in the world, but amazing catch by Rawlins, taking it almost to center field. So it'll be first down, Red Bombers. And a dive play up to the left, snuffed immediately by that defensive line of the Tigers. It'll be second down and basically nine to go.
Matt LaFleur with the carry. He picks up two. It'll be second and eight, UNB.
Jonah Rawlines looking downfield. Oh, ball knocked out. That's a fumble. Taken by number 40 at Dalhousie. It should be a Dalhousie ball. Head referee indicates that it is.
That
was number 40, Luke Smith, who caused that fumble and able to recover it. So it's first down, Tigers. So some impressive offensive plays by the Red Bombers, but not able to capitalize, and especially in the first series where the Tigers took it down to UNB's 20 or 15-yard line. No score with 6:30 left in the first quarter. Gabrielli looking to his left, flushed out. UNB able to take him down, number 15 with the tackle for the Red Bombers. That's Jaron Killam.
Keeps, scrambles, brought down by Jaron Killam. Jaron Killam.
And with a very small loss, it's going to be second down, and let's call it 11 for the Tigers. Red Bomber coaching staff imploring their defense to come up big on this play. Gabrielli looking on the screen pass. They're successful in the completion, but not able to get a first down. That was number 18, Caden Kwong, who caught the ball. They'll be short. So are they going to set up for the field goal, or are they going to run a play here? Looks like Dalhousie's going to go for it. They've got about 2.5, 3 yard. It's a gain in order to get that first down. Keeping everybody in tight. Dive play up the middle, off to the right-hand side. UNB makes early contact. Difficult to know. I don't think they made it. They had to get to the 25 for the first down. And
contact by Nick Appleby.
If you look at the line judge, he's got him right on the line. And the so UNB defense is telling us they weren't successful. We're looking for the Pat Fairweather, the head referee, to give us a signal. And that's it. Red Bombers were successful in stopping the Tigers, so it's first down and 10, Red Bombers, just outside their own 25-yard line. So lots of offense in this first quarter, but no scoring. Must be frustrating for the respective offensive coordinators, but for football fans, we're seeing a lot of great plays and a lot of great defense when their backs are up against the wall. So 4:55 left in the first quarter. No score. Rawlines looks downfield. He's flushed out to the left-hand side. He's got lots of room, and he's able to slide for a first down, Red Bombers.
Rawlins with the carry.
Right about his 37-yard line. Rawlins looking very comfortable in this game. And the UNB offense showing lots of diversity with running and passing and still being able to adapt to the adjustments that the Dalhousie defense has been able to put in front of them. First down and 10, Red Bombers just over their own 35-yard line. Rawlins looking deep downfield on the post pattern. Wide open. Number 84 for the Red Bombers. Nick Parker with the first down. Let's see a replay, please. See, Rawlins wasn't looking at anybody other than Parker. Post pattern right down the middle. Right on the numbers. Deeper into Tiger territory are the Red Bombers marching. First down and 10, 3:30 left in the first quarter. Quick pass down the middle again. Oh! Nick Parker couldn't find the handle and then was punished by Logan Hillier of Dalhousie.
He's hit by Logan Hillier. Pass is incomplete.
I think Nick was thinking about what happened after he caught the ball instead of focusing that ball coming in. It was right into his hands. It'll be second down and 10 for the Red Bombers. Good pass by Rawlins. Once again, Rawlins looking downfield over the middle. Wide open, number 21, scooting around the right-hand side. And he's out of bounds for a first down and goal for the Red Bombers. That's Jace Taylor for the Red Bombers. And you can see how he came from the left-hand side across to the right-hand side. Was able to make a great gain for the Red Bombers. So just out probably around the... I'm going to say the 8-yard line. First down and goal from the 8-yard line. Red Bombers knocking on the door. Looks over the middle, flushed out. He's scrambling, should have lots of room, dives in for a touchdown. Red Bombers, Jonah Rawlines.
He's met at the goal line by Nathan Johnson, but spins in and scores the first touchdown of the game.
So Jonah Rawlines showing he can throw, he can run, he can jump into the end zone for a touchdown. 6-0 Red Bombers, 2:34 left in the first quarter, setting up for the extra point. And if Justin was here, he'd be quick to point out we have to see where this ball lands on the BMO Center roof, how successful they are with the extra point. We've got a Tiger player down. So let's see if we can do a little filler here.
Hi, I'm Vince Sturgeon, head coach of the UNB Red Bombers. You're watching UNB Red Bombers football. Go Bombers.
That was head coach Vince Sturgeon. Not looking intense at all. Probably even more intense down on the field. So Red Bombers setting up for the extra point. Kick is good. Doesn't quite make the roof.
Justin Remillard
was successful with the extra point. So the score stands 7 Red Bombers. No score, Dalhousie Tigers. Nothing. 2:34 left in the first quarter. So as we change, of course, to mention in other football games, CIS yesterday, Bishops was successful over Acadia 22-10. Mount Allison won their game 13-11 over St. Mary's University. And Concordia was able to defeat McGill 40-23. Red Bombers setting up to give the ball to the Tigers. Good kick to the right-hand side of the Tigers' field, being returned by number 12. Taken relatively quickly, just over their own 30-yard line.
Ethan Lord with the return.
Ethan Lord was the returner for the Tigers, and they're going to be first down and 10 from their own 32-yard line.
It'll be a first down, Tigers.
So because I don't have Justin to bounce over, in this date in history, to let you know, this is when the Cuban Missile Crisis started. So there's a bit of a missile crisis the Dalhousie defense is dealing with UNB right now, as they're passing very well. Dive play to the right-hand side, taken quickly by the Red Bombers. Stopped for a short gain. That was number 95, responsible for the tackle, Grant Mazerol for the Red Bombers. Second down and about 8 yards to go. And it's a sweep to the left-hand side, end around. Number 6 for Dalhousie, Ben Coates was the ball carrier, but failed to gain the 10 yards, so it's going to be third down and about 4. Looks like Dalhousie's going to have to give up the ball.
It'll be third and 4 for the Tigers.
So with 1:29 left in the first quarter, UNB should retain or get possession of the ball. Good punt by Dalhousie. Taken cleanly by UNB. Good block.
Cap and X kick.
It'll be first down for UNB. Number 6, Ben Coates, was the tackler for the Tigers.
He brings it to the UNB 45. It'll be first down Reds.
And for all you music lovers out there, this happens to be the birthday of Franz Liszt. Been trying to get our music coordinator to play some Liszt on the field, but he's not number one on Gary's list. I apologize. First down, Red Bombers. And it's a toss to the right for LaFleur. Able to make a great gain. See a flag on the play. About a 6 yard gain, depending on what the call is.
Like a gain of six on the play. There is a flag.
We're looking for the indication on what the infraction was. Pat Fairweather, head referee, tells us it was rough play and face mask against the Dalhousie Tigers, so that should be a 15-yard penalty, taking the Red Bombers back into Tigers territory. So Rawlins is marching the Red Bombers. So 49 seconds left in the first quarter. Looks like a little bit of rain coming down on the field. Early motion, looks downfield, flushed out to the left-hand side, and he's sacked. Number 90 for the Tigers was the tackler in the backfield. That's Logan Steves.
By number 90, Logan Steves. Loss of three on the play. It'll be second and 13 for UNB.
Rollins looking downfield, passes down. Good catch by number 80. Officials say that that is good.
Justin Remillard.
Justin Remillard one more time with the catch. That's going to be another first down. Red Bombers marching. And that's the end of the first quarter. With Red Bombers 7, Dalhousie Tigers no score.
Hi, my name is Pat Forbes, slot back, 2010-2011. You're watching Red Bombers football. Go Bombers.
And that was current Red Bomber alumni Pat Forbes showing that good looks does skip a generation. Sorry, Maureen. That was for you. So, before we begin the second quarter, again, Red Bombers looking good. If we saw the first couple of plays, Tigers were marching, Red Bombers were marching. Neither team was able to get a score, but on the last drive, Jonah Rawlines was able to scramble in for a touchdown, so they're up by 7 points, and this will be the first play for the second quarter. First down and 10, just inside their own 35. Lots of motion. This is a dive for LaFleur. He's got lots of room up the left-hand side. Should be a first down, Red Bombers. Matt LaFleur. Great run on that play.
Rawlins gives to Matt LaFleur, and he rumbles for a first down. Or he's brought down by number 37, Ethan Griffard.
Defensive coaches of Dalhousie, you have to wonder why Cam Hayward isn't running, but Matt LaFleur is doing a marvelous job. It's first down to the right-hand side. Catch is good for a short gain by Thomas Hoyt.
Pass complete to Thomas Hoyt. He's covered by Nathan Johnston.
Looks like he got about 5 yards. It'll be second down and 5. Right on the doorstep of the Tigers' goal line. And it's a dive play for LaFleur off to the right-hand side. Couple of holes made by that vaunted offensive line of the Red Bombers. Looks like he's short of a first down, right to the 10-yard line. So a decision by the Red Bombers if they're going to go for the yard and a half for the first down, or are they going to go for the field goal? On comes Cam Hayward. No surprise there. LeFleur coming off. So I doubt there's a mystery on who for the Red Bombers is going to have the ball, but is it going to be up the middle? Is it going to be to the left, to the right? And it's up the middle to the left. Cam Hayward, touchdown! Red Bombers. Don't see any flags on the play. That is a touchdown. And as we'll see on the replay, no surprise here. Right down the middle. Big touchdown for the Red Bombers. Now setting up for the extra point. Justin Remillard is successful with the kick. That makes the score 14. Red Bombers, no score. Dalhousie Tigers with 12:58 left in the second quarter.
Hi, I'm Marty Flynn. I played for the UNB Red Bombers from 74 to 77, and again in 79. I was a wide receiver, and you're watching Red Bomber Football Live.
And a big hello from Marty Flynn, who's one of the members of the Flynn family, who are famous in Red Bomber history, committing a number of brothers to play for the Red Bombers through their years. So great start for the Red Bombers. Justin Remillard set to kick off to the Tigers. Fielded cleanly by Owen McConnell. He's able to scoot to the right-hand side, but taken down quickly. Number six by the Red Bombers, that's Brandon Lemieux.
Fields the kick. He's brought down very quickly by number six, Brandon Lemieux.
So first down and 10 for the Tigers, just inside their own 25-yard line. Trip receivers to the left-hand side of Gabrielli. Dive play. He's able to make a great gain. Just... looks like it could be a first down.
To Javi Reyes Landry.
And he is successful with a first down.
More than 10 yards. It's a first down, Tigers.
And Javi Reyes Landry was the ball carrier for the Tigers. Big hole, huge gain by the Tigers. And it's a fumble. Let's see if they call that a fumble over the ground. I think the official's calling it down. Number 21, that was, again, Javier Rez Landry with that big gain. Let's see if we've got a replay. He's scooting to the left-hand side, but as we can see, it's a real close call, but as we know, the ground can't force a fumble, so it looks like it was contact with the ground that had the ball come out, so it's going to be first down in Reds territory. Motion on the line, flare pass out to the right-hand side, it's complete. But taken down quickly. That was number six, Ben Coates, for the Tigers.
He picks up three. It's second and seven for the Tigers.
And if you can hear the dulcet tones of Jeff Landine, our on-field announcer, he tells us that there's another 7 yards left for another first down for the Tigers.
Tiger
Gabrielli looking to the left-hand side. Flare pass to the outside. It's complete. Oh, first two tackles unsuccessful. It's first down out of bounds. That's number eight, David Shamsuddin Kiara. And good run to the left-hand side by number 21.
Reyes Landry with the carry.
Reyes Landry again.
Brought down by Jordan Colpitz, but a gain of seven. It'll be second and three, Dalhousie.
So second down and two. Knocking on the Reds' doorstep. Flushed up the middle. Gabrielli. Looks like a first down for the Tigers.
Picks up the first down. It'll be first and goal, Dalhousie.
Dive play up the middle. Taken just to the 5-yard line. That'll be second down and goal.
He pushes forward for five. Make that four. It'll be second and goal from the six.
Flushed out the middle. Gabrielli close. It looks like, yes, it's a touchdown, Tigers.
Gabrielli beats and he falls forward into the end zone. That's a Dalhousie Tigers touchdown.
And Gabrielli was divine with that scramble to the left-hand side, able to get a touchdown for the Tigers. Score is now 14-6, favor of UNB. Setting up for the extra point is okay, Kapenik. And it's good. And Justin would be happy to know it almost went over the other side of the BMO field. So with 8:34 gone in the second quarter, Dalhousie Tigers 7, UNB 14. So while we're setting up for the kickoff, so again, apologies to everybody, but Justin has forced me to this. This day in history, 1797, was the first parachutist in history. André Jacques Ganarin in Paris dropped from a hydrogen balloon 3,200 feet to be the first man to survive a parachute drop. And of course, that was the inspiration of Leonardo da Vinci. So the Tigers about to kick off now. Taken cleanly. Thomas Hoyt able to come up the middle, found a small seam. Should be down on the 30. First down and 10.
Thomas Hoyt on the return. He's brought down by Xavier Kays. And a host of Tigers. It'll be first down, UNB Reds.
So let's see if the Reds offense is able to take advantage of Jonah Rawlines from his two successful drives earlier. Tiger defense set. Deep ball over the middle. Looks incomplete. Justin Remillard was the intended receiver. It's going to be second down and 10. Big pass again for Remillard. Looks like a first down. Bombers.
Remillard again. And he has a gain of 14. It's a first down. UNB.
So it'll be first down on their own 45-yard line. 7:35 left in the second quarter. And it's a dive play up the middle. Good gap. Looks like LeFleur was a ball carrier. Yes, he was. Looks like about a 6-yard gain. Second down and 4. Auckland flushed from the pocket, and the Tigers are able to take him down quickly. It's going to be a loss of about 2 yards. It's going to be third down.
He's stopped in the backfield by Luke Smith. There are flags on the play.
We hear there's flags on the play. Head referee talking to the Dalhousie coaches. Call is holding against UNB. That's declined. It's going to be third down.
Holding called against UNB.
And that's a timeout.
Dalhousie will decline that. It'll be third down and 6.
My mistake. No timeout on the play. UNB punting to Dalhousie. Owen McConnell is the deepest receiver for the Tigers. Good punt by UNB. Number 12, Ethan Lord was a returner for the Tigers. They're going to scrimmage first down and 10 from, looks like, their own 40-yard line. 6:19 left in the second quarter. So if we've got a beauty of a game, it's important to tell you that in famous birthdays in 1943, Catherine Deneuve was born on October 22nd. And for anybody who loves blueberries, they would remember Catherine Deneuve. And we have new quarterback for Dalhousie. That's 16, Noah Glover. Here comes Gabrielli just to test us on our roster control.
Gain of 2 on the play. It'll be second and 8.
Second and 8 for the Tigers. 5:37 left in the second quarter. Looks to his left, ball over the middle. And a host
back in a quarterback
of Reds to take him down.
His pass complete to Colton Allen.
Colton Allen was the receiver. Took at least 4 people to bring him down. So Tigers are now in UNB territory. Sweep out to the right-hand side. And number 18, Caden Kwong was stopped for, I presume, a loss.
Sharp was having no part of that.
Small loss. It'll be second down and about 11.
The loss of one on the play. It'll be second and 11.
Gabrielli looking to the left-hand side. Ball is up. And it is. What do we call? Oh, he caught it for a second, but it's ruled incomplete.
Intended for Ethan Lord.
Ethan Lord was the intended receiver. We're going to see this on the replay. Good ball by Gabrielli. Right into his mitts. But a hard catch. And good defense on by UNB number two, Caleb McLaughlin.
There's a flag.
Looks like there was a flag on the play.
And the flag is a
rough play. I'm guessing that the signal meant hands to the face, which would be a 15-yard penalty. So Tigers successful via a penalty. Getting deeper into UNB territory. Setting up with trip receivers to the left-hand side of Gabrielli. Dive play up the middle. Good gain.
Caden Kwong with the carry. He's close to the first down.
Caden Kwong. And it's a scramble to the right-hand side. And he's successful. Gabrielli for the first down. Able to get a couple of yards past that first down marker. It's going to be first down for the Tigers. Ooh, penalty against the Tigers. That's rough play. That's going to be taken back 15 yards. So after they'd made the gain on the play, it's going to be second and 17. Pat Fairweather, the head referee, giving us that signal. So the head referee giveth, the head referee taketh away.
It'll be second and 19 for the Tigers.
With 3 minutes left in the second quarter, this is a big play for both teams. Motion left-hand side. Looking to the left is Gabrielli over the middle. Oh, player was wide open. Number six, Ben Coates, but the ball was behind him. It's going to be third down and 17. It looks like the Tigers are going to have to give up the ball to UNB here.
That's the 3 minute warning. There's 3 minutes left in the half.
LaFleur deep for Bombers. High punt. LeFleur unable to catch the handle. They're diving for it. It looks like UNB was lucky. They're able to pick it up. And as the strains of Start Me Up come over the field with 2:34 left in the second quarter.
And UNB retains possession.
It's UNB possession. Oh, and no yards call on the play. So a little bit of lack of discipline on the Tigers' part in the last three or four plays has made it a little easier for UNB to be in a position to see if they can get some points before the half is over.
A no-yards call will move the ball 15 yards further up. It'll be first down.
Cam Hayward in the backfield. And it's a dive over the middle left-hand side. Good gain. Close to the 35-yard line.
It'll be second and six, UNB.
6 yards to go for a first down. 2:29 left in the second quarter. Trips to the right of Rawlines. Looks downfield. Ball's deep. And while there was contact, we see no flag. It's going to be an incomplete pass.
Nick Parker.
Nick Parker was the intended receiver. It's going to be third down. UNB.
Incomplete. It'll be third and six.
And Parker was looking for the call. None forthcoming. Good snap, clean punt. UNB special teams doing a fine job of stopping any considerable gain by Owen McConnell.
By number five, Owen McConnell.
It's going to be first down and 10 from their own 43-yard line, it looks like, for the Tigers. Just a couple of ticks, less than 2 minutes left in the second quarter. Head referee is, don't know what this call is. Something against, there was a penalty against Dalhousie. I didn't see whether it was rough play or what, but it looks like it's UNB is scrimmaging.
Penalty on the play gave UNB a first down. It'll be first down Reds.
Rawlins looking downfield, right down the middle. Oh, overthrown.
Rawlins pass intended for Remillard.
Remillard was the intended receiver. He had him open, but just wasn't able to drop that ball in. It's going to be second down and 10. UNB certainly found its passing game tonight. Let's see if it's another one. Again, Remillard looking to the right-hand side. Wide open with a catch. Should be right on the marker for the first down.
Pass complete to Thomas Hoyt.
That's Thomas Hoyt. Official looks like he marked him just short. Third down.
Mark is short, just short of the first down. It'll be third and one, UNB.
And as I see a white helmet in that huddle, I think Cam Hayward is likely going to receive the ball from Jonah Rawlines. No, it's a quarterback sneak off to the left-hand side. And he's away. First down.
Rawlines keeps. He gets the 1 yard plus another nine. It'll be a first down. UNB inside Dalhousie territory.
Looks like it's on the Tiger 45-yard line. Successful third down gamble. And with 1:40 left in the quarter, lots of time for UNB to put up a score. Early motion, Rawlines looking downfield. Deep to the right-hand side. No flags on the play. Can we see a replay of that? I want to see if the defender happened to turn around and try and play that ball.
Ethan Grefford with the...
You see the defender doesn't even look back to the ball. Interesting non-call by the referee. Be second down and 10. Clock has stopped at 1:22. Play action. Flare pass out to the right-hand side. Lots of room. Unsuccessful in the first down, but he was successful getting over the 40-yard line. It's going to be third down. Red Bombers.
Taylor picks up four. It'll be third and six, UNB.
Big decision by UNB. Looks like they're going for it. And he's flushed out. Lots of room. Flare pass. Looks intercepted by the Tigers. Number three, Logan Hillier.
Intercepted by Logan Hillier.
Big play by the Tiger defense.
There's a flag on the play.
Let's see if we can see where the infraction is. Big interception. Conference with the officials, see what the decision is. Pat Fairweather coming out to let everybody know what the decision was. Rough play against the Tigers. So UNB able to march closer to the... We've got rough play, but that was a dead ball foul after the interception. So Tigers are able to get possession, but it's going to be first down and 10.
After the interception. So it'll be first down, Tigers, but inside their own 10.
So less than a minute left in the second quarter.
Less than a minute left to play.
UNB unfortunate they weren't able to keep the drive, but they've got Tigers deep in their own, near their own end zone. Gabrielli, oh, it's a fumble. Picked up by the Red Bombers. I don't see any flags. First down, Reds.
Picked up by Jordan Colpitz. It'll be first and goal, UNB.
And they're just outside the 10-yard line, so it's first down and 10. So with 45 seconds left, big turnaround, UNB threatening. Play action to the right-hand side. Oh, big tackle by number 15, Max Parker for the Tigers. Timeout called by the Red Bombers.
Lots of eight on the play. Timeout called by UNB.
So let's do a quick recap. We've got 14 UNB, 7 for Dalhousie. 39 seconds left. It's been very much a back and forth contest, but certainly I think the story in the second quarter was the number of penalties that the Tigers have incurred, something like 4 or 5 in the last 4 to 5 minutes, which has put them in this situation, not to mention the fumble by Gabrielli. So the Reds' brain trust on offense, it's probably called two plays here, just in case the first one is incomplete, to see if they're going to get a touchdown. Of course, they have the option of going for a field goal if their first attempt is unsuccessful. So it's second and 19 with a first down available just over the 1 yard line. Snap looks deep to the left-hand side. And I think we've got an interception. If we can see a replay here.
Picked off again, this time by Nathan Johnson. Flag on the play.
Great position by the Tigers' defensive back, but there's a flag on the play. See what the call is? They're talking to Dalhousie, so I would assume it's against UNB. It's procedure. Against the Bombers, that would be declined. So UNB unsuccessful again with their attempt to get points. Big sigh of relief by the Dalhousie coaching staff with 33 seconds left in the second quarter. Reds 14, Dalhousie Tigers 7. Dive play off to the right-hand side. Big gain. And that's a stalwart, number 12, Ethan Lord for the Tigers.
Caden Kwong with the carry. He brings it out to the 40. It'll be first down Dalhousie.
Looks like holding against the Tigers. It's first down repeated.
Called against Dalhousie. That'll take the ball back.
Dive play again up the middle. Big gain by the Tigers.
Kwong with the carry again, and he gets out.
Looks like Antonio Peterson with the tackle for UNB.
The first down Tigers with 20 seconds left.
Inexplicably, we don't understand where that first down comes from after that penalty, but it's a first down for the Tigers. 19 seconds left. Deep to the left-hand side. And incomplete. Second down.
David Shamsun, Seattle.
Here we got the replay.
It'll be second down, Dalhousie.
Really good play by number 25, Daniel Lavak. By the Bombers, it's going to be second down. 11 seconds left for the Tigers. Dive play again up the middle. Good initial gain. And he's still going. Looks like he's got a first down. Don't see any flags.
Determined run by Caden Kwong. He picks up a first down.
It's a first down for the Tigers with 3 seconds left in the second quarter. Pat Fairweather, the head referee, whistles time in. Another running play up the middle. Good gain. Nice tackle by 18.
Kwong with the carry.
Sebastian Brown. That should
be
it for the second quarter. So, at the end of two quarters, UNB Red Bombers 14, Dalhousie Tigers 7. I hope all of you are enjoying our broadcast. We are enjoying bringing it to you. We're going to take a break for another 15 or 20 minutes, and we hope to see you back at the beginning of the third quarter. And welcome back, everybody, with start of what looks to be a great second half. Score right now is 14 for the UNB Reds and 7 for the Tigers on a pretty important game. Right now, everything's tied up as far as first place in the Atlantic Football League. So this would be bragging rights, not to mention the Tigers are going to have a four-point game against Holland College a week from now. So important for them to get momentum, and we're off. Clean take. Good gap up the middle.
Thomas Hoyt on the return.
Thomas Hoyt on the return.
Nathan Johnson. It'll be first down, Red.
So we get a first down on the UNB 29-yard line. So UNB having lots of success in the air, just unfortunate not being able to put up more than 14 points right now. Dive for Hayward up the middle. Looks like about 4 yards.
With the carry.
Tigers defense doing a good job of limiting those gains. If you remember a few weeks ago when UNB was playing against Holland College, that offensive line of UNB was dominating Holland College, but they're not able to do so against the Tigers. Matter of fact, it was only a 1 yard gain, so it's second down and 9. Oh, looked like he was going to do a flare pass, but he's sacked. Number 33 by the Tigers.
By number 33,
Owen Hamilton White. And it was a defense, we don't have a replay, but it was a defensive back by the Tigers who was forcing Rawlines to bring that ball back in, which set up that sack. So UNB having to give up the ball to the Tigers. Flushed out. And huge play for the Tigers, catching the Red Bombers deep in their own end.
Justin Remillard brought down by Ethan Grefford. Turnover on downs.
So Tigers knocking on the Reds' goal line.
Just outside the Reds, the Reds 10.
Big defensive play by the Tigers. Oh, and a return defensive play by UNB. Number 30 with a big tackle, Ethan Ray.
Bobby Reyes Landry. Loss of 3 on the play.
Reds coaching staff imploring the defense to pick up their coverage. Trip receivers to the left-hand side of Gabrielli. Looks left right away. Flare pass incomplete. Two Reds in the way of that pass. It'll be third down.
Ball's incomplete, it'll be third.
And about 13.
And 13 for the Tigers.
So question mark, it looks like the Tigers are going to set up for a field goal. Kopenick setting up for the kick. Gabrielli the hold. Kick looks good. Indication is that it is. So with 12-11 left in the third quarter, it is the Tigers 10, UNB Reds 14.
We have a ticket for the 50-50 draw. We're looking for a green ticket with the number 564-30431. That's 564-30431. It's a green ticket. The winner needs to go see Natasha at the front gate. You're going home $125 richer.
So as Jeff Landine is telling the on-field crowd about the 50-50 winner, you can see the excitement ripple through the crowd. First down, UNB. Deep down the middle. Big defensive play by 81 of the Tigers. That was Matt Irvin.
Justin Remillard.
Justin Remillard was here. We watch the replay. It's a good ball. Remillard is open, but a better defensive play by 81. Just able to come over the top and knock the ball down. Textbook defensive back play. Second down, 10. Motion to the left-hand side. Looks downfield. Flare pass. Wide open. And he's away. He could go all the way. Touchdown, Bombers!
Rawlins pass complete to number 84, Nick Parker.
Big play for Rawlins to Parker.
And 80 yards later.
And we don't see any flags. This will be an exciting replay. As you can see the flare pass, he's able to get by two Tigers and just puts his nose forward right down the sideline. Exciting play. Score now 20 Reds, 10 Tigers. Setting up for the extra point. And it's good. Doesn't quite make the roof as Justin would be watching. So again, we've got 21 for the Reds, 10 for Dalhousie. That touchdown was for you, Cyril. I'm sure the coaching staff sent that up. So exciting beginning to the third quarter. Again, as we mentioned, both teams are tied at first place with Holland College just behind them. Holland College not playing this weekend, but setting up for a big contest because of the missed football game because of the hurricane. The next contest between Dalhousie and Holland College is going to be worth 4 points, which is certainly going to be setting up bragging rights for what will eventually set up for the playoffs. So November 4th, UNB plays Holland College, and November 11th is scheduled for the championship game. So please stay tuned to see how UNB is doing in that contest. UNB set to kick the ball back to the Tigers with an 11-point lead. So UNB looking none the worse for wear for the setback that they had against Holland College a week ago. Oh, it's a short kick. Taken cleanly by the Tigers, number 4, Colton Allen.
Short kick.
So an aggressive move by UNB, but Tigers were able to cover, so it's going to be first down and 10 Tigers on their own 47-48 yard line.
From their own 49 yard line.
Dive play to the left-hand side. Short gain by the Tigers. Still short of center field. So it looks like it's about another 6 yards before Tigers would be able to get a first down. 10:55 left in the third quarter. Patty Murphy helping the UNB defense get ready. Gabrielli tried to get that ball away, but was flushed out. He's able to scramble. Looks like he's got a first down.
Gabrielli with the carry, stopped by Ethan Ray. Buddy picks up the first down.
It is a first down for the Tigers.
First down, Tigers.
And you can see it was a good rush by UNB, but not able to get a hold of Gabrielli before he was able to get a first down. So inside UNB territory, just inside the 50-yard line. And a flare pass out to the left-hand side. Able to get outside of containment. Rudely pushed out of bounds, but quick to show us his number six, Ben Coates, that it's another first down for the Tigers. Tigers marching. And another dive play taken quickly by the UNB defense. First to make contact, but getting up slowly.
Ethan Ray with the tackle.
Was Antonio Peterson was able to make that initial contact. Looked a little shaken up, but none the worse for wear. It's going to be second down. A little less than a yard gain. Given past performance, I would imagine Gabrielli's going to try and put this in the air with trips to the right. UNB with a good rush. Not able to get a hold of Gabrielli. He's still going. Looking for the signal. I don't see anything from the official.
Gabrielli with the scramble.
Looks like he was put out of bounds just before he got to the goal line. Big scramble by Gabrielli. Here we see on the replay. Take a look at the field judge near the goal line right there. And yes, Gabrielli is forced out just before he gets to the goal line. So it's going to be first and goal. And if we've got the Rolling Stones, Can You Hear Me Knocking would be an appropriate tune right now. And it's a dive to the left-hand side. And it's a touchdown, Tigers. As we see in the replay, second effort does the trick for Caden Kwong. So for all you Atlantic Football League fans, this is the furthest thing from 3 yards in a cloud of dust. Great offense by both teams as the Tigers set up for the extra point. And our head referee, Pat, tells us that that point is good. So with 8:26 remaining in the third quarter, UNB Reds 21, Dalhousie Tigers 17.
Hi, my name is Rick Cuthbertson. I played for the Bombers back in 74, 75, and 76. My number was 37, and you're watching Bombers football. Go Bombers.
We want to thank Rico Cuthbertson for saying hello to everybody. Defensive back from Red Bombers 1970s. And again, as we're getting ready for the Tigers to kick off. Yesterday, University of Alberta defeated University of Manitoba 35-25. And looks like we're all set to go. Good kick by the Tigers. Big gap opens up. He's free to the left-hand side and flushed out of bounds by the kicker. Great gain by the Reds on their own 48-yard line. They're going to scrimmage first down and 10.
43 3-yard line.
Dom Hall with the return. Special teams stepping up for the Reds. Big answer to that Tiger drive. And we see Cam Hayward in the backfield for the Reds. Early motion. Looks downfield. Oh, my goodness. Right into the breadbasket of number 15, Max Parker of the Tigers, but not able to bring it in.
Defended by Max Parker.
Very lucky for the Reds. Second down, 10. Motion to the right-hand side. Flushed upfield. Wide open. Big play. Thomas Hoyt. Nice post pattern by the Reds. Able to break the first tackle. Three Tigers to take him down. It's going to be first down on 33-yard line of the Tigers for UNB. Hayward in the backfield. He gets the ball, looks to the left-hand side. Short gain. Dalhousie defensive line is doing a fine job stopping that UNB running game. They're really forcing the Reds to go to the air, but the Reds have been successful with this passing game. So it's second down with 7 minutes left in the third quarter. UNB looking to put some more points on the board. Is that Tiger defense going to be able to stop them? Rawlins setting up. He's got trips to the right-hand side. Post pattern down the middle. It's short. Ball skipped. Tigers trying to convince people that they've got an interception, but no, it's incomplete. Number 37 for the Tigers, who I can't find his number on my roster, was able to come up with that ball, but it's going to be third down. And about 8, we're going to call it for UNB. Looks like we got a player down.
Hi, I'm Donnie Davis, and I played quarterback for the old UNB Red Bombers back in the 70s, and then I coached for probably 5-6 years after that. Anyway, go Bombers, go, and have a great game.
And thank you to Donnie Davis, not only a stalwart quarterback for the Red Bombers of the 70s, but also the inspiration behind bringing high school football back to Fredericton. And here's a replay here of the wayward pass. Lovely ball, but no Red receiver within the vicinity. So it's third down. Looks like UNB is going to go and see if they can get a first down here. Rawlins looking downfield, flush from the pocket. He's able to scramble.
Rawlins keeps.
Could be close to a first down. That's what I think close the indication is from the head referee.
Brought down by Owen Hamilton White.
It is a first down.
It is a first down.
UNB still marching. They're on the 27-yard line of the Tigers. First down and 10. It's a blitz by the Tigers. Ball's up to the right-hand side. Oh, Hoyt is able to bring it in. Touchdown!
Thomas Hoyt with the reception and the touchdown for the UNB Reds.
Jonah Rawlines able to read that blitz by the Tiger defense and find Hoyt wide open on the right-hand side. You'll see that defensive player came close, but Hoyt's able to bring it in and just scurries up the sideline for another UNB Reds touchdown. Scores now 27 for UNB, setting up for the extra point. Extra point is good, and Remillard is able to find the roof of the BMO Center. So with 5:51 left in the third quarter, UNB Reds 28, Dalhousie Tigers 17. And here's the touchdown play again. Really nice catch by Hoyt, able to put that in. So Rawlins, whether that was the set play or he's able to identify that blitz, and that was the device where they were able to handle it. It's a great execution by UNB. So we're seeing a pretty exciting offensive exposition by both teams today. If you like offense, this is a game to watch. So again, UNB in a position where the Tigers would have to score twice to either tie or catch up to what UNB has been able to accumulate. Let's see if they can keep the pedal to the metal. Moderate kick to the right-hand side, taken cleanly by the Tigers. Number 25, Mitch Page, was the Tiger that was able to bring that in. Looks like the Tigers will scrimmage first down and 10 from their own 35 with 5:46 left in the third quarter. Down 11 points. Sean McIntyre and Andre Gauguin of the Tigers seeing what game plan they can come up. And it's a bit of play action. Gabrielli able to keep the ball for a good gain. Looks like about 6 or 7 yards.
Gabrielli keeps.
Should be second down and about three.
Jordan Colpitz in the middle. Gain of 7. He's second and three.
Chairman Emeritus Rick Rivers tells me that Gabrielli is a freshman quarterback and looks well seasoned behind that Tiger offensive line. Dive play again, able to find a hole on second effort, still going. And over center field, it'll be first down for the Tigers.
He gets more than up for the first down.
That's Caden Kwong, the ball carrier. We've got a Tiger down in a little bit of distress. No, he seems all right.
First down Tigers.
That's Obi Odima, who looked like he got a knock, but he's right back up. So a couple of first downs for the Tigers with 4:24 left in the third quarter. It's a keeper to the right-hand side by Gabrielli. UNB able to contain the run with Jordan Colpitz, a tackle for UNB. It's like a gain of about six. It's six. It looks like it's about 5 yards to go, second down. Trip receivers to the left of Gabrielli. And it's a dive play up the middle. Good hole. Looks like they're successful with the first down.
Kwong on the carry, and he picks up another Tigers first down.
Caden Kwong is the workhorse for the Tigers this afternoon. First down and 10, just outside the UNB 40-yard line. Gabrielli getting the signal from the Tigers brain trust. Again, trip receivers to the left-hand side. Another dive play by Caden Kwong. Shorter gain this time. Number 30 from UNB, Ethan Ray, able to get the tackle.
Gain of 4, second and 6, Dalhousie.
So this is a big play for the Tigers offense. Probably a little outside of field goal range. Sure, they're hoping to get the first down, and of course UNB's defense hoping for exactly the opposite. 2:25 left in the third quarter. Play action, Gabrielli looking downfield, screen pass, but taken right away. Ball's out, but I think he would have been ruled down. That was number 25, Daniel Levac, was able to stop any serious gain by the Tigers. So from the 35-yard line, it's third down and a little more than 4 yards. We see the Dalhousie kicker out. Looks like they're going to try for a field goal. And given the quarterback is a holder, I wouldn't put a fake past them. Kicks away. A significantly good kick from more than 40 yards. Okay, Kopenick, big field goal. Let's watch how cleanly this is done. He had lots of room. Could have kicked that from much further. So with 1:28 left in the third quarter, UNB Reds 28, Dalhousie Tigers 20. So if you remember the final game from last year, Tigers were able to make a significant comeback with 2-3 minutes left in the game. So with UNB up by 8 points, by no means is the fait accompli. But it would mean the best that the Tigers could do with one single score would be to get a touchdown and a two-point conversion. So it's going to be first down and 10 for UNB Reds on their own 35-yard line. Looking outside the left-hand side. Oh, it's a good catch. Remillard, good catch and a first down.
Justin Remillard.
Justin Remillard being the workhorse on the passing play for UNB.
A first down and gets the Reds over half.
So one play and the Reds are in Tiger territory. 1:12 left in the third quarter. Early motion. Oh, LaFleur able to take the handoff from Rawlines.
Gain of 2 on the play. It'll be second and 8.
Didn't quite get to execute, I'm sure, the way that they wrote that up, but still, they're able to get a couple of yards. Rawlines getting the signal from the UNB coaches now. I'm sure they want to take their time moving towards the Tiger goal line. And now a little play action. They've got a blitz flushed from the end. Short of a first down, but able to make a gain. Rawlines was able to get away from that Tiger rush.
He picks up another 5 yards. It'll be third and 2 for UNB.
Looks like third down, 2.5, 3 yards. Be an interesting call. I think they're going to see if they can get a first down. Motion to the right. Oh, big Tiger play. 33 with the blitz for the Tigers. Owen Hamilton White. See if we've got a replay on this. You'll see Rawlines is looking downfield, but 33 comes right up the gut. Not a block in sight and is able to sack UNB quarterback to set up a first down and 10 just inside center field for the Tigers. And that is the end of the third quarter with an 8-point difference between the UNB Reds and the Dalhousie Tigers. Score 28-20. Fourth quarter about to start.
Start of the fourth quarter. We've got got a tight one.
Dive up the middle. Looks like about a 3 or 4 yard gain.
Javi Reyes Landry. Gain of 5. It'll be second and 5.
Javier Reyes Landry was the ball carrier for the Tigers. Change of personnel for the UNB defense. Looks like about a 5 yard difference before they can get a first down for the Tigers. Trip receivers to Gabrielli's left-hand side. Play action. Gabrielli able to keep it close to a first down. But if we look at the line judge, he's not quite far enough.
Ethan Ray tackles him short of first down marker, but it'll be third and one.
Dalhousie offense putting a little bit more beef on the offensive line. Looks like they're going to go for the first down. We're going to have to talk to the music coordinator why he would use Eye of the Tiger when UNB needs to come up with a defense. And it's a quarterback sneak. Looks like with the inspiration of Eye of the Tiger in their ears, Tigers were able to get a first down. Just over the 45-yard line, it's first down and 10 for the Tigers with 13:15 left in the game. Gabrielli's moving to his right-hand side. It's caught and taken out of bounds is number 9, Matt Lawton, for the Tigers. Second down.
Gabrielli's pass complete to Matt Lawton.
Little more than 5 yards before they can get a first down.
It'll be second and 6, Tigers.
And it's keeper to the left-hand side. Gabrielli almost able to get away from number 33, but not quite. Jordan Colpitz with the tackle. Third down and short. Quarterback sneak by Gabrielli. Reds are indicating that they may have been able to stop him. Tigers obviously have a separate opinion.
Stopped by Ethan Ray. We'll wait and see if he got the necessary yard.
Looks like we're going to have a measurement.
We're going to wait for a measurement.
Just what all you football fans have been waiting for, a measurement on the play. One of the most exciting plays of football. And as the stick crew move glacially towards the play, and as they bring the stick taut, looks like they're short. Reds are successful in stopping the Tigers. It is first down and 10 UNB.
Let the turnover on down.
As you see, Gabrielli was there, but number 30, Ethan Ray, able to stop him before he was able to get any momentum. big stop for UNB. Sweep to the right-hand side. Big collision. Just
to close Cam to Hayward, and he
Cam Hayward.
To go out of bounds.
Close to a first down, but not quite.
It'll be second and short for UNB.
Second down for UNB Reds. Deep pass down the middle, post pattern. It's almost there for number 21, Jace Taylor.
That's incomplete. It'll be a third and one.
Shades of the 1970s Edmonton Eskimos with second and short going for a deep ball. Wilkinson was typically the quarterback that would try those things. But it's a third down and short for the Reds. Hoping to gain another first down. Cam Hayward, big gap up the middle, still trucking. First down.
Cam Hayward gets 1 yard and then he gets another 20.
Inside Tiger territory for a first down. And we'll see on the replay. Watch a big hole open up to the left-hand side. Great ceiling block by the fullback on that play. Really impressive running play. Now, if UNB is able to keep this running play up, this is exactly where they want it, to take some time off the clock, gain some more territory. And they're going to do just that. Cam Hayward, big hole again up the left-hand side. Looks like he got about a four-yard gain. Second down and six. Matt LaFleur coming in. Cam Hayward coming out. UNB has been successful just to the left of center. We'll see if they think that that's a soft spot in the Dalhousie defensive line again. Yeah. Looking downfield over the middle. Incomplete thrown behind LaFleur. It's going to be third down and about seven.
Intended for Justin Remillard. Ball's incomplete. It'll be third and six.
UNB looks like they're going to be prudent, for the lack of a better term here, and punt the ball away. See if they can keep the Tigers deep in their territory with 9 minutes and 6 seconds left in the game. Waiting for Cam Hayward to be the long snapper. Good clean snap. Nice high spiral deep into Tiger territory. Good coverage by UNB special teams, and he's down just over the 5 yard line. So with 8:43 left in the game, UNB Reds 28, Dalhousie 20.
He's brought down by the Reds.
So with the new Canadian football rules, that's brought out to...
Ball comes out to the 20-yard line. It'll be first down, Dalhousie.
And again, Jeff Landine tells us that this is on the 20-yard line, and it's going to be first down for the Tigers. 8:43 left in the game. 8-point difference. Big run up the middle by the Tigers, just short, I think, of a first down.
Caden Kwong with the carry.
Caden Kwong, the workhorse.
Seven, it'll be second and three. Yeah.
Play action, running to the right-hand side. Oh, unsuccessful. Number 9, Matt Lawton was the intended receiver. It's going to be third down.
That's incomplete. It'll be third down and 4.
And Prudence decides to make another entrance into the football game as the Tiger coaches are decided to punt and improve their field position before UNB takes the ball over again. See if I can get Craig to play Dear Prudence. Oh, fumbled snap. Not very deep. I think the officials blew that up because the punt, if the punter put his knee down, then that would mean it would be a dead ball there. And that's a big turnover for UNB. Looks like it's going to be first down. And just outside of the 12-yard line for the Reds. Not far away from the Tiger goal line. .740 left in the game. Reds threatening. Cam Hayward in the backfield. It's a sweep to the left-hand side. Hayward looking for the... Oh, no, and he's able to brought down by the ankles. Number 33 for the Tigers. Owen Hamilton-White. That's the second big tackle that he's made for the Tigers in the second half.
With a shoestring tackle on Cam Hayward. Okay. Gain of only 2 on the pitch out. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Reds threatening. Looking left. Receiver went right. The ball went left. That's incomplete. It's going to be third down. I would imagine that UNB is going to kick a field goal to see if they can put this into a 2-score territory and make it 31. Certainly well within their kicker's range. And I don't think I predicted that correctly. Oh, yes, they are. Okay. So kicking just inside the 20-yard line. And looking for the signal. That is good. Field goal by UNB late in the game. So the score now is the UNB Reds 31, Dalhousie 20. And if we remember from last year's final game, it was a similar situation where UNB had a chance to put the game away with a field goal and were unsuccessful. So this is a big change of turn of events for UNB Reds right now. 6:44 left in the game. 11 points difference between UNB and the Tigers. Tiger offense looking for the ball on the left hash mark to begin their series of plays from their own 35. And it's a dive play up the middle with hardly a gain at all for 21, Javier Reyes-Landry.
But Antonio Peterson wasn't letting him by.
Antonio Peterson, the red wall that would not be moved. 6:19 left in the game. 2nd and 10. Gabrielli looks downfield to the right-hand side, deep down the middle. And he's successful to number 12, Ethan Lord, a big catch.
Ethan Lord.
So big gain by the Tigers into UNB territory, just on the 41-yard line.
With a first down in UNB territory.
Both offenses putting on a show for you this afternoon. We hope you're enjoying UNB Reds football. Trips left for Gabrielli. Dive up the middle.
Reyes Landry
one more time.
8-5, it'll be second and 5.
Play coming in from the sidelines to Gabrielli. Less than 5 minutes left in the game. Looks like a blitz coming from the Red Bombers. Quick pass out to the right-hand side, taken right away. Number 4, Colton Allen for the Tigers with the reception. Looks like another third down and short situation for the Tigers. UNB Reds looking to see if they can stop another one of these plays. Gabrielle keeping. 33. Jordan Colpitz trying to get to him early for Gabrielli. Based on the reaction of the players, I think the Tigers were successful in getting over the line of the scrimmage for the first down. See the replay.
He falls forward for a first down.
We'll see Colpitz coming off a 10-meter diving board to try and stop Gabrielli, but it's going to be first down for the Tigers. 3:40 left in the game on the UNB Reds' 30-yard line. Dive play for Reyes. Short, if any, gain whatsoever for Reyes Landry.
Reyes Lambert.
It's going to be setting up a second down.
Landry with the carry.
Tiger coaches have to be concerned here because they've only got 3 minutes left. They've got to score twice to catch up with the UNB Reds. Given the time on the clock and given the situation, you have to expect that Gabrielli's going to put the ball in the air. He's got trip receivers to his left-hand side. He steps back, looks over the middle, deep over the right-hand side. It's intercepted by the Reds. And he's going to return it out of his own end zone. Still going. There's a gap. He's still going. He's got a gap out to the right-hand side. Coming up to the 50-yard line and out of bounds. Big play for UNB number 18, Sebastian Brown. Let's see a replay on that.
50 yards on the field.
See the ball deep into the end zone. Sebastian Brown able to avoid a couple of Tigers and said, let's go for a run. Good blocking by the UNB defense. He found a huge gap to the right-hand side. Skirts another tackle. But I got a suspicion we got a penalty flag on the play.
Oh, there is a flag on the play.
And did I see a holding signal? Okay, it's holding after the interception. So UNB retains possession, but loses that significant game that Brown was able to get on that run. So exciting play, still good for the UNB Reds, and they retain possession.
Called on UNB after the interception.
Can't see the hold on the replay, but
UNB still
none the worse for wear.
Retains the ball. It'll be first down Reds.
So Coach Spurgeon will certainly be trying to make sure that UNB is able to get a couple of first downs, but more importantly, to see how much time they can take off the clock. There's your three-minute warning with 2:28 left in the game. Cam Hayward in the backfield. Oh, it's an end around. Jace Taylor, the running back for the Reds.
Jace Taylor. Johnson.
Second down in the better part of 10. The important part for UNB is to make sure that the clock still runs. Probably going to see another running play. And it is Cam Hayward up the middle. He's got a gap. Stopped by a couple of Tigers, but not able to get much of a gain. Maybe three, maximum 4 yards.
He's met by Luke Smith at the line of scrimmage.
It's going to be third down. But importantly, because it was a running play, the clock will still go. I don't see that there's any signal from Dalhousie for a timeout.
Third and long for the Reds.
3 seconds, less than 2 minutes left in the game. 31 UNB Reds, 20 Dalhousie Tigers. Tigers will have to score twice in order to catch up with UNB where the score stands now. Important exchange from Cam Hayward to LaFleur for this punt. Oh, I'm sorry, Remillard. Timeout Tigers.
Timeout called by the Tigers.
Hi. I'm Jim Bourne, the former UNB football coach, and you're watching the Red Bombers football game. Go Bombers.
And thanks, Jim Bourne, former Red Bomber head coach from 1970s, early 80s. So UNB Reds in the driver's seat right now. Cam Hayward setting up for the long snap. Oh, looks like UNB is going to give up a 2-point safety.
Remillard.
So that would make the score 31 UNB Reds, 22 Dalhousie.
The safety gives Dalhousie.
But important that it still means that Tigers have to score twice, and a significant difference in field position.
And Dalhousie will get the ball.
And I think Dalhousie is selected to start on their own 35. And that's complete to number four, Colton Allen.
Pass complete to Colton Allen. Driven out of bounds by Sebastian Brown.
Looks like about an 8-yard gain, but more importantly for Dalhousie, that stops the clock. Blitz coming from UNB. Forcing Gabrielli out of the pocket. He's scrambling to his right-hand side, still going. And he's taken out of bounds, so he's got a first down and stops the clock right at midfield. So if you look at the scoreboard, the UNB's up by an all-important 9 points because there's no way the Tigers can beat them without scoring twice. And it's complete. Tigers able to keep the ball. Big gain by Ben Coates.
And he rumbles a long ways into UNB territory.
Shades of last year's final game where the Tigers are marching on UNB. Trying to pull one out of the fire. First down, Tigers. Gabrielli looks to the left-hand side. Oh, ball right in the hands of number 12, Ethan Lord, but incomplete.
It'll be second and 10.
Good news for the Tigers, the clock stops.
Timeout called by UNB.
Timeout called by UNB to make sure that the defense, make sure that they get all their signals together. This is an important series. Last thing they want to do is give up a touchdown. So to remind you, both teams are currently in first place. The winner here would be in then by themselves in first place. And if UNB retains their lead here, then it puts Tigers in an interesting position where they've got a four-point game against Holland College next weekend. Gabrielli coming in from the bench. Probably has instructions for at least two plays if they're unsuccessful with their second down attempt. So with 1:15 in the game, second down and 10, Tigers to snap the ball. Gabrielli looks left, ball's in the air, and it's incomplete. Intended receiver was number 13, Robbie Sneath. Ethan Lord.
That'll bring up third and 10.
Third down, I think Dalhousie's looking to kick a field goal here, which would then make it a one-score game. And chances are we'll have the second most exciting play in football other than the third down measurement, but a short kick. Ooh. Ball is wide.
Yep, an X kick.
So that means that Dalhousie only gets 1 point, which still puts him in a situation where there's an 8 point difference. And somehow if Dalhousie can get the ball back, score a touchdown and get a 2 point conversion, sets up a tie. 1:05 left. UNB Reds first down and 10. First down, UNB Reds. Keeper up the middle, big play. Looks like a first down, UNB.
Jonah Rawlines keeps. And he picks up a gain of 13. It's a first down.
Jonah Rawlines with a first down for the UNB Reds. Important play at this juncture of the game. Let's see if the Tigers call a timeout. No, they do not. Not yet. Time's in. Pat Fairweather, a head referee. Jonah Rawlines gives the ball to Cam Hayward.
Cam Hayward with the carry.
Tigers claiming there was a fumble on the play.
He stopped in the backfield.
Let's see if on the replay we can see the ball coming loose. Don't see that, Cam. Really can't see that anything. Now we've got a timeout by the Tigers. So 35 seconds left in the game. UNB Reds 31, Dalhousie Tigers 23. First place in the Atlantic Football League on the line. Spirits of Dickie Flynn and Tony Proudfoot can be felt at BMO Field, urging the UNB Reds on. Second down and 14 for UNB. Trips right. Jonah Rawlines. It's a dive play for LaFleur. He's got all kinds of room on the left-hand side. He's still going. He's short of a first down.
Matt LaFleur keeps his footing. Gets to within
Matt LaFleur looks like he's got another three, 4 yards.
Third down and four.
But No timeouts left for Dalhousie, and the clock will run. Head referee Pat Fairweather puts time in. Jonah Rawlines taking his time, getting instructions from the bench. Certainly no hurry here at 3rd and 4. Might be taking the clock right down to the end and then call a timeout for themselves. And that's precisely what they do. So with 10 seconds left, UNB calls a timeout. 3rd down and 4. So do you take the gamble? I mean, you've got a couple of options here. You punt to put the Tigers deeper into their own end zone. You take the attempt that you're going to be able to get a first down and retain possession. Or do you take a knee and give Dalhousie a chance to get 8 points from 45 yards away? Looks like UNB's going have selected to punt the ball. Time is in. Good snap. Punt in between the area, and it's gone out of bounds.
Goes out of bounds.
So with 5 seconds left in the game from their own 35-yard line, Dalhousie Tigers are going to do their best to come up with a touchdown and attempt a two-point conversion to see if they can tie this game. Ball snapped to Gabrielli's looking to the right-hand side. Here comes a hook and ladder. And he's still. And the ball looks out of bounds. We're looking for if there's any flags on the field. I think that's it. Looking for Pat Fairweather, the head referee, to signal. That is the game. So with the final whistle, it is UNB Reds 31, Dalhousie Tigers 23 in an exciting Atlantic football contest with UNB now firmly in third place in the Atlantic Football League. Thanks so much for joining us on this Sunday. Looking forward to seeing you in a couple of weeks when UNB's going to play Holland College. Have a great Sunday. Take care, everybody. God bless.